The Variance Waterfall Chart is an extension included in the visualization bundle with the Qlik Sense September 2019 release. You can use the Variance Waterfall Chart to show the variance between two measures over the different values of a dimension. To create a Variance Waterfall Chart, select Custom Object and then Visualization Bundle. Next, drag and drop a Variance Waterfall Chart onto the sheet. Click the Add Dimension button to select the bridge dimension. In this case, we select quarter as the dimension. Click the first Add Measure button to select the measure to use as start value. In this example, we select the sum of cost of sales. In the Properties panel, we are going to label it Actual, and then we change the number formatting to Money. In addition, we customize the format pattern. Next, we are going to add a second measure to set the end value. We will use the sum of sales, and we will label it as Forecast. As before, change the number formatting to Money, and then customize the format pattern. We have an empty value here, so we are going to exclude the null values from the dimension. Now we can change the appearance of the waterfall. In Colors and Legend, switch the Colors option to Custom. Then change the colors of the positive and negative values. And the colors of the start and end values. Next, in the x-axis, position the value labels on top of the waterfall. In the second example, we are going to use a dimension that contains a large number of values. We'll use product name. We are going to compare the sum of sales as a negative value and the sum of discount. Next, order by sales. Change the sorting option so it sorts numerically in ascending order. As you can see, the bars are compressed to display all the product values, and you can select specific values inside the chart. You can also limit the number of values displayed in the waterfall chart. For example, we'll select City as dimension. Then for the start value, we'll use the sum of cost of sales divided by 1,000 and label it Actual. We'll use the sum of sales divided by 1,000 as end value and label it Forecast. As you can see, the waterfall shows the results for all cities. In this case, we are going to reduce the data displayed by limiting the results to the top 5 countries. And here you have the waterfall chart we just created. That concludes this video. Thanks for watching.